There are many phone manufacturers like Xiaomi, Realme and Oppo that are coming up with amazing budget range smartphones and mid-range smartphones. Until last year, Samsung was actually struggling to compete with these brands, especially in India, in the budget smartphones. That's when Samsung earlier this year decided to launch amazing Galaxy M series. So Samsung launched phones like M10, M20 and M30, which offers great design, better hardware and amazing display at amazing and reasonable prices. So what is it now that Samsung has to offer to us? Well, it is the upgraded version of Samsung Galaxy M30, which is Samsung Galaxy M30s. Compared to its predecessor, M30s comes with bigger battery, better camera system and a new chip at a starting price of ₹13,999. Hi, you're watching India Today Tech. I am Pavni Jain and this is the full review of Samsung Galaxy M30s. I'm gonna tell you everything about this phone, the design, the display, cameras, performance and battery. So let's get into the video. In terms of design, M30s is not very different than M30. It's again the plastic body and I don't mind any plastic body, but there's something about this one that I don't like. Maybe it's the color. So M30s comes in three different colors: opal black, sapphire blue and pearl white. This one is sapphire blue, which is a mix of blue and turquoise. But if you prefer subtle colors, then take my advice and go for either white or black. The phone is easy to hold and because of the plastic panel, the phone feels really light at 188 grams. Oh wait, this phone also packs 6000 mAh battery, right? And this is actually very impressive because with 6000 mAh battery, the phone doesn't feel heavy or thick at all. You get a triple camera setup on the back. The camera module gets wider for the LED flash and 48 megapixel branding. Bezels are slim on the sides, but you get a thick chin. They say you still get around 90% screen to body ratio, which is great. The keys of the phone, which are the unlock button and the volume rocker, are placed on the right side of the frame and these are not really defined. On the bottom, you get a 3.5mm headphone jack, a Type-C port and a speaker grill. You get the SIM tray on the left side of the frame where you can place two nano SIM cards and a micro SD card, which is expandable up to 512GB. Samsung S30s has a 6.4-inch Full HD Plus display with a resolution of 2340 by 1080. The Super AMOLED Infinity U display is bright and attractive as you would expect from a Samsung display. It offers great viewing angles as well. When I was watching Mr. Bean on this phone, I found the screen offers slightly dull colors, but that can be because of the settings. You can always choose between vivid or natural mode in setting as per your liking to make the colors on the screen look punchy. You will find good contrast on this phone with deeper blacks. The screen of this phone is great for watching videos or reading text. The videos and text both appear very sharp. And this phone also supports Wideband L1 certification, which means you can stream content on platforms like Netflix and Prime Video in true HD resolution. This phone gets an upgrade in the camera department as well. The phone offers 48 megapixel main sensor using its own GM1 sensor. The camera module also includes an 8 megapixel wide angle lens and a 5 megapixel depth sensor. On the front, you get a 16 megapixel front facing camera. The 48 megapixel main sensor captures the photo in 12 megapixel by default using the technology called pixel binning, which means it stitches 4 pixels in one to get a brighter and attractive picture. You can also shoot in the raw 48 megapixel. For that, you just need to play a little bit with the settings. You just have to change the ratio from 3:4 to 3:4M. Going by the picture quality of M30s, the phone clicks beautiful pictures. And if you use the 12 megapixel default mode, you get even brighter pictures. You can also switch to wide angle lens on this phone to capture more in one single frame, but it works best in daylight. In no lighting conditions, the pictures look a little grainy. Have a look at a few shots that I have clicked using this phone. Coming to the selfies, I found the pictures okay-ish. The 16 megapixel front facing camera clicks better pictures in daylight, otherwise the photos are really noisy and dull. And using the live focus mode, which is the portrait mode, it's not a good idea either. Have a look. The camera app is quite basic and easy to use. You get different modes to play with, like food, night, pano, pro, live focus, photo, video, super slow-mo, and hyperlapse. So you can just go creative and try using these different modes to capture different stuff. Recording one sample video on M30s. I'm really sorry, I can't even open my eyes. It's too sunny today and I forgot to bring my sunglasses anyway. The point is to check the exposure, colors and contrast on this phone, and you can tell me if you like the quality of this phone or not. And there's one more thing that I want to tell you about M30s, that you can switch between regular and ultra wide angle lens while recording a video. Oops, you cannot. I am sorry. Thanks to the camera person. So you cannot switch between the lenses. And this video, we are recording it. We are not using a tripod or a selfie stick or anything. It's handheld. So just decide yourself if you like the quality or not, and let me know in the comment section down below. This phone comes with 10 nanometer based Exynos 9611 octa-core chipset. It's the same system on chip that powers the new Galaxy A50s. The phone feels really smooth. In fact, I find the performance of Exynos 9611 chipset better than Snapdragon 665 chipset, which powers Realme 5. This phone runs games like PUBG and Asphalt 9 in high graphics by default. So there was no frame drop and no lagginess at all. Speaking of the software, just like other Samsung phones, M30s comes with one UI based on Android 9 Pie. It is comparatively clean UI experience than skins like ColorOS and FunTouchOS. One UI does not offer a lot of bloatware, apart from a few preloaded apps like Snapchat, Netflix, Daily Hunt and Prime Video. Some of these apps are useful while others can be uninstalled. Browsing through the UI is smooth and has been designed to make it easy for one-handed usage. While there are some useful features with One UI, such as digital well-being and always-on display, you should also be prepared for occasional ads to randomly show up in the notification panel. As I've already mentioned, the M30s comes with 6000 mAh battery and it's really huge. And this is the key highlight of this phone. This is the first smartphone in India to come with this massive battery, other than the Asus ROG Phone 2. For this phone, Samsung says that the phone can last up to 2 days. Well, that's true. I have watched back-to-back videos, I have played games, and I have been on the social media 24/7. And this phone actually lasts me around 2 days on a single charge. Isn't that fantastic? What else would you need in a budget smartphone? But unfortunately, the M30s gets only 15 watt fast charger in the box, much like M30. So it takes around more than 2 hours to charge the massive 6000 mAh battery, which is quite slow. Overall, the Galaxy M30s is an impressive upgrade to M30 with bigger battery and new chipset. This phone comes in two storage options. One is 4GB of RAM with 64GB of internal storage, priced at ₹13,999. And the other one is 6GB of RAM with 128GB of internal storage, priced at ₹16,999. At these prices, there are many more options like Realme 5 Pro and Redmi Note 7 Pro. But Galaxy M30s is definitely a good choice, especially when you want to buy a phone with a long-lasting battery. While 6000 mAh battery is definitely the selling point of this phone, but one shouldn't forget that you also get Super AMOLED display and amazing triple camera setup. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you still have any doubts or questions regarding Galaxy M30s, put it in the comment section down below and hit the like button if you like this video, share it with your friends and subscribe to India Today Tech.